It's about worship, mostly about worship. You understand? True worshipers worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. The true worshipers worship God, worship Jesus in spirit and in truth. If you are a true worshiper in this place right now, keep your heart and your mind connected to God right now. You see, God is not a respecter of anybody. God is not a respecter of any human being whatsoever. You understand? This house, he says in his word, my house shall be called a house of prayers. You understand? So when you come into the house of God and you have things on your mind, you have issues on your mind, you have hatred on your mind, and you have bitterness on your mind, be rest assured that there will be nothing for you on that day. Be rest assured that you will not receive anything from God. If you come into the house of God and you have envy on your mind, if you have envy and jealousy and malice on your mind, be rest assured that you're not going to receive anything from God. Hallelujah. If you come into the church and you have what you have on your mind is nothing clean, right? If you're having something against your brother or your sister in the house of God, be rest assured that you will not receive anything from God. Rather, you're bringing in judgment upon yourself. Hallelujah. So I'm giving everybody the opportunity right now to clear their minds right now. I'm giving everybody the opportunity right now to clear your minds. Just have a clean and clear conscience right now. We're going to worship God. We're going to worship God. God delights in worship. Just take this opportunity right now to clear your conscience. If there's anything that is on your mind that is supposed to stop you from receiving from God today, clear it out of your mind right now. Otherwise, you're going to be receiving judgment in this place today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just clear your mind right now, even as we're about to worship. Even through it all. Through it all. I learned to trust in Jesus. I learned to trust in God. Through it all. Through it all. I learned to depend upon His word. Oh, I learned to depend upon His word. Through it all, through it all, through it all, I learned to trust in Jesus.
I learned to trust in God. Through it all,
through it all, I learned to depend upon His word. Was I falling on my ears? Son of God is closing. Yes. And He walks with me, and He talks with me, and He tells me that I am His own, and the joy that we share as we tarry there. His place, remember, is no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear Him. Hallelujah. Our life is just like a puff of a smoke. You understand? Our life is like a puff of a smoke. This morning I was reading something, an article online about a man who was the first man in England to win £18 million on the lotto. The first man to win it. And how did the man die? He died like nothing. There was not even an epitaph on his on the tombstone. There was nothing. You understand? And the moments that the man got the money just changed him. He got a divorce. He destroyed his life. He destroyed his family. You understand? Vanity of vanity. Vanity upon vanity. It means nothing. You understand? We're constantly running after the wrong things. The Bible says here clearly that only the fear of the Lord is everlasting. Only the word of God is everlasting. As it says also in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 2 or so. The same thing. Only the word of God stays forever. You understand? Psalm 90 verse 12 also says, teach us to number our days, O God. Teach us to number our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. You understand? When we are busy pursuing after things of the world, we become fools. When we are busy pursuing the things that do not profit, we become fools. And when we keep our eyes away from God and start running after the things of the world, we become fools. We fall into all kinds of traps. We fall into all kinds of snares that has been set by the enemy. You understand? So the psalmist is saying, teach us, O Lord, to number our days, that we may gain the heart of wisdom. Hallelujah. So today we're going to pray. We're going to pray. We're going to lift up our hands towards heaven right now. We're going to say, oh Lord, teach me to number my days, oh God, that I may gain a heart of wisdom. In the mighty name of Jesus, somebody just pray sincerely from your hearts. Teach me, oh God, to number my days. Teach me, oh God, to number my days, that my eyes shall be disconnected from the things of this world. That my eyes shall be disconnected, oh God, from the things that the real men, oh God, from the things that cause men to perish, oh God. Father, that my eyes shall be disconnected from the schemes of this world, oh God. That my eyes shall be connected unto you, Lord. Father, teach me, oh God, to number my days. Teach me, oh God, to number my days. Teach us, oh God, to number our days. In the mighty name of Jesus, somebody just pray. Teach us, Lord, to number our days, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Teach us, Lord, to number our days. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In December, last year, December 12, 2016, I had a revelation which I shared on Facebook. I posted it on Facebook last year, December. That was like 9 months ago. I saw that there was a destruction coming to America. This was 9 months ago. You saw when I posted it, right? And I posted it on Facebook. And I said that I saw like thunders and lightning, and that is in the form of the wrath of God coming to America. I posted it on Facebook. A lot of people probably didn't take me seriously. And I was asking for people to pray for America. 9 months, behold, 9 months after the prophecy, it came to pass. Exactly 9 months. That's like the month, the time that a woman gives birth to a child. Exactly 9 months. The destruction was about to be birthed. You understand? The destruction was still in the womb cooking. It took exactly 9 months for it to be unleashed upon the land. Because of sin. I said it last year. I posted it there. It's open. It's open for everyone to see. Because of sin. So today we're going to pray for America. Alright? God is not happy with America. God is not happy with America right now. God is not happy with the evil that is going on around the world. God is not happy with same-sex marriage. God is not happy with sex outside of marriage. God is not happy with the destruction. God is not happy with fraud. God is not happy with evil. Period. God is not happy with evil. You understand? He's not happy with immorality that has been shown on TV constantly. God is not happy with this thing. God is not happy with the way people are rejecting him and they are turning their backs on him. He's not happy with it. So we're going to pray right now for America, because that's what the Lord has called us to do. The Lord has called us to be watchmen on the wall. So therefore, let's just pray for America right now. Father, I pray for your mercy upon the nation of America. Lord, we pray, oh God, for your mercy, Lord, upon the nation of America. In the mighty name of my Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, as many as are going through this distress, oh God, Lord, I pray that you will come to their rescue, oh God. I pray that you will come to their rescue, Father. In the mighty name of my Lord Jesus Christ, I pray, oh God, that you will save them, oh God. I pray, oh God, for your mercy upon the nation of America. Someone just pray for America right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I pray, oh God, for your mercy. For your mercy, oh God. For your mercy, oh God, upon America, oh God. in the mighty name of my Lord Jesus Christ. Let that be your prayer point even as you go home today. Let it be your prayer point. God does not delight in the destruction of the wicked. God does not delight in the destruction of the wicked. But the Bible says in Amos chapter 3, starting from verse 6 to 7, he says, when the destruction comes upon the earth, it will not be the Lord that brought it. You understand? And he says, God does not accept. He first reveals it to his servants, the prophets. And the reason he reveals it to his servants is so that they may pray. But when the watchman blows a trumpet and nobody takes it into consideration, then there shall be a sword on the land. Hallelujah. So let's go home today and keep on praying for America in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And last night as well, early this morning around 12:30, I had another revelation, and it's concerning Nigeria. All right, we're going to pray for Nigeria as well. I saw that there was a northern leader that died. Okay. He was carrying a lot of goods. You understand? There were a lot of people following him, and he died, possibly from poisoning. A northern leader in Nigeria died. All right, I saw that clearly early this morning, around 12:30 in the morning. I saw that. So we're gonna pray for Nigeria. We're gonna pray for Africa as a whole, that the Lord Himself will have mercy upon the land, will have mercy upon the nation. And I could see in that revelation that the leader, some people who were surrounding that northern leader, they were like his enemies. It was as if it was planned. It was as if it was planned by the police, even by the police department and the army department. They knew about that man's destruction. And it was as if they planned to poison him. And they were saying, I heard the commander saying that even if he does not die right now, that he will be shot dead. You understand? So we have to remember Nigeria in prayers. I know there's a lot of evil going on in Nigeria, but Nigeria is still a prayerful nation. We have to remember that country in prayers, in everything we do, in the mighty name of my Lord Jesus Christ. We have to pray for the Lord's mercy to extend unto that nation, in the mighty name of my Lord Jesus Christ. So wherever you are, across the nations of the earth, as many as will be watching this on Facebook, as many as will be watching it on YouTube, remember to pray for Nigeria. I saw that there was a northern leader who's going to die, possibly from poisoning. All right, so let's pray for that leader in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So, Father, we thank you, Lord, for this wonderful time of worship in your presence.